It's no secret. Inventory's low and we've got 12 buyers for every house, driving those prices up. Just because home sellers are getting multiple offers on their homes doesn't necessarily mean the transaction's going to close. In fact, there's a rising number of homes that went under contract quickly, but now having to go back on the market. So how can you, as seller, have a successful sales transaction, avoid pitfalls, and actually make it to the closing table the first time around? Hi, I'm Lisa Kelly, Lakeland Homes and Lifestyles with Premier Realty. Today I'm going to share a few things that I'm seeing that's causing these deals to fail and what you can do to prevent this from happening to you. Homeowners that are selling think that a hot seller's market is fast, easy money. After all, the definition of a hot seller's market is low inventory combined with a lot of buyers looking for that perfect home, right? It's true. A hot seller's market means that you're going to sell at or above asking price. I'm even seeing some pretty crazy contingency waivers as well. However, there's some pitfalls that home sellers need to be aware of before they start watching that money roll in. I'm seeing homes go pending, meaning going under contract, in lightning speed these days. In some cases, a home stays on the market for a matter of hours. But I'm also seeing more homes come back on the market just as quickly. In some of these cases, the home buyer had a home inspection done that turned up repairs that ended up being a deal breaker for both sides. Now the seller has to put the house back on the market. No doubt the new potential buyers are going to want to know what happened and have the question in their mind, what's wrong with this house? This stigma may affect the seller's bottom line now. To avoid this, consider getting a home inspection done prior to listing your home. This way you can provide an accurate picture to the buyers from the very get-go. Yes, a home inspection is going to cost you around $350, but in my opinion, it's money well spent to avoid the risk and cost of the unknowns. Okay, your home inspection is perfect now, and your buyers are anxious to close, but there's a problem with the title, and it looks like it's going to take a bit of time to get it cleared up. Your buyers can't afford to wait. They've got deadlines too. So here we go. You got to put the house back on the market. In most states, the time frame for getting that title commitment is clearly defined in the purchase contract. To avoid these potential problems, do not wait until you have a buyer to have this done. Do the title work immediately once you list the house. The title company or the attorney's office handling the closing is responsible for providing this service. And don't worry, you don't have to pay for this until your property closes. Turn to your realtor for advice. In most cases, homeowners are totally unaware of any title defects, especially if you may be selling a home that you've inherited or have special circumstances regarding a divorce. There could be many reasons why a title commitment cannot be issued initially. The good news is most all title defects can be corrected. Just maybe take a little bit of time. Another thing I'm seeing a lot of in this hot seller's market is for sale by owners, aka FSBOs. As a homeowner in a hot seller's market, I totally understand the impression is that buyers are going to flock in groves and there's really no need to pay a realtor or commission fees. I'm a fully licensed realtor. I totally get it. In this seller's market, it's incredibly easy to walk into your front yard, put a sign up. Before you get back inside, your phone starts ringing. It's what happens next that gets most FSBOs in trouble. If you as property owner are unfamiliar with how to write, negotiate, and defend a real estate purchase contract, especially a Florida real estate purchase contract, you are setting yourself up for one big headache. Not to mention the time that you're going to lose with unqualified buyers. It's worse. You may not actually net every dollar your home is worth. For the purposes of this video, I can't go into all the reasons why it's not a good idea to try to sell on your own in this hot seller's market, but if you'd like to have a chat, click the 15 with Lisa link here or wherever you're watching this. Pick a time and day that works for you. I would love to talk to you. Being in a seller's market, a seller has a better chance of selling as is without having to make any major updates. However, depending on the price range and your neighborhood, it's a good idea to sit down with a local realtor who's familiar with the area to determine whether or not significant improvements is warranted prior to listing. It could mean the difference between potentially leaving your hard-earned money and equity on the table. For a detailed explanation of how selling as is would affect your personal situation, you'll want to check out my prior video. One of the most common reasons why I'm seeing homes that were previously pended go back on the market is because the seller chose an offer that was simply too good to be true. Buyers are under tremendous pressure these days, and sometimes, unintentionally, they make promises in their offers that they cannot keep. They do this to take the house off the market while they diligently try to make good on that offer. For example, you might get an offer for $10,000 over list price, the buyer even waiving the inspection period and giving you extra time to move out. Oh my gosh, this is an offer from heaven. You couldn't sign that agreement fast enough. Everybody's happy, the buyers are getting their paperwork into the lender, life is good. Then the appraisal comes in at list price. But your purchase contract is for $10,000 above list. That means the buyer is going to have to come to closing with an additional $10,000 in closing, or the seller is going to have to adjust the purchase price to meet the appraised value. If the parties can't negotiate a remedy, the contract will fail. It's been 2 weeks now, and now your house has got to go back on the market. Don't get caught up choosing the wrong offer just because it looks like a dream on paper. You're definitely going to want to check out my prior video here. An experienced listing agent will know how to best advise you by vetting all your buyers, wording your contract to protect your best interest, and offering you guidance based on your individual circumstances and goals. And as a side note, when you receive multiple offers on your property and only one is chosen, please make sure that your realtor responds to those other buyers' agents and those buyers. Tell them that you're thankful for the offer. Not only is this a professional courtesy, it also bridges your relationship with that potential buyer. Just in case. Just because we're in a hot seller's market right now does not guarantee that you're going to get multiple offers and for over list price. I know you've heard stories about your neighbor down the street selling their house for $20,000 over list price in 2 days. But you may not know all the circumstances regarding that sale. Home prices can differ dramatically within neighborhoods. Criteria not apparent on the MLS might make a house sell for more. Like a great layout, lots of light or decorator colors, or mature landscaping. These are just a few examples of things that might tip buyers into a frenzy into multiple offers and higher prices. Your home may not have the extras, but take solace that you are selling in a hot seller's market and most likely will have no problem getting full price for your home opposed to selling in a down market. And if you happen to luck out and your sales proceeds are more than you ever imagined, feel free to pop that champagne at closing. I'm Lisa Kelly, Lakeland Homes and Lifestyles with Premier Realty. And until then, I'll see you on the next one.